Good old Mario Kart. Nintendo's flagship racing series sure has come a long way from its conception on the Super Nintendo, and September 26, 2019 marks the latest entry in a long line of quality titles which have evolved mostly for the better. Nintendo has had their fair share of criticism for how they always seem to lag behind the industry when adapting to modern standards, be it hardware, online capabilities, DLC, the works. But if there's one thing I've been thankful for until now, it's how they've stuck to their guns regarding the pay-to-win model, which has, in my humble opinion, hindered the mobile gaming landscape and continues to poison the console market by the likes of Epic Games and EA. We saw the launch of Super Mario Run a ways back, and the one-time payment system to unlock the entire experience apparently rubbed too many frugal penny pinchers and children the wrong way. I actually prefer this model in theory, since you're not forced to cough up so much money for loot boxes, which have a random chance of giving you an edge in an uneven playing field. But Nintendo has gone a bit too far this time. Mario Kart Tour starts off promising enough, giving you a few different control options that are a little on the weird side, but you get used to the compromises after practicing for a while. The graphics are beautiful, comparable to Mario Kart 8 on the Nintendo Switch, with levels and music that are sure to lure you in with their familiarity and iconic stage design and soundtracks. Like you might expect, there is no turning around or reversing in this mobile iteration. One little screw up and it's probably best to start a stage over from the beginning, but that's okay. Nintendo has gone on record saying they don't want the full fat experiences on Android or iOS. They want to lure potential customers to bite-sized versions of their intellectual properties so that they may end up buying a Switch or Switch Lite in the future, and to introduce newcomers to their characters and higher quality offerings. Mario Kart Tour isn't exactly a bad game. In fact, I've had a fair amount of enjoyment playing it over the last couple of days, but boy oh boy is it a bad Nintendo game in terms of how it seems to prey on you as you progress through its courses. Let me put it this way, after a certain point, even if you're a pro and complete each course in first place, you won't be unlocking stars or acing levels unless you've unlocked a favored character for a specific course. Which you won't be doing unless you have rubies. Ah, rubies. Most games hook you by initially granting you a decent amount of its in-game premium currency in the hopes that you'll buy more. But then Nintendo had to go and make a gold pass that costs $5 a month. That's right, a month. That is more expensive than the monthly membership for the Switch Online, which includes many more perks by comparison, such as online play and a collection of classic Nintendo games. Speaking of online play, for a series known for its multiplayer emphasis, online play isn't available at launch, but a little button on the home screen hints to you that it will be available in the future. Gee, that's awfully nice of them, since there seems to be little reason to add friends in this game, aside from seeing who spent the most money to unlock the characters that give you more points in each level. I was in 5th place on a specific track, but because I had the right character, Kart and Glider, I still managed to unlock every star for that level. Yet while I was in 1st place with the wrong character, I still had 2 stars I wasn't able to collect. I know I might sound a bit harsh, and overall, Mario Kart Tour is still a relatively faithful entry to the series in essence, but that essence is being buried behind a shallow paywall that really makes you wonder if your time wouldn't be better spent playing any of the other versions of Mario Kart available. Now it's a little too early to pass a complete and total judgment of Mario Kart Tour, since it has a certain level of enjoyability and potential that could turn things around in the right direction, but as it stands, I would be wary to its limitations. As it's not a completely skill-based game, I actually recommend activating the free trial of the Gold Pass and promptly ending the subscription so that you have more of an opportunity to unlock things for the first 2 weeks. But I ask, what do you think of Mario Kart Tour, or the current state of mobile gaming in general? Leave your thoughts and suggestions below, and consider liking or subscribing to support me. Thank you oh so much for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.